Hello, my name is Inga and I'm a PhD student in the new established research group Molecular Taxonomy of Marine Organisms at the German Center for Marine Biodiversity Research in Wilhelmshaven, Germany. The aim of our research group is to test and develop molecular methods for the identification of the marine metazoan fauna of the North Sea, aiding efforts to monitor biodiversity patterns and change. One focus of our research is the building up of sequence libraries of DNA barcodes, as well as supplementary nuclear markers, which are used for reliable species identification. In this context, environmental samples, in particular zooplankton, are analyzed with a special emphasis on meroplankton larvae, which are difficult to identify on species level based on morphological characters. Since May 2010 to June 2011, samples were collected in different regions of the North Sea, including zooplankton samples of different mesh sizes and whole seasonal cycles. Numerous specimens of a variety of taxa have been collected and fixed in absolute ethanol for further molecular studies. Each specimen identified for DNA extraction has been photographed and received a unique so-called Multax label as a basis for further working steps. The digital image and, if possible, the specimen itself, as well as the associated DNA extract, have been deposited in the Multax collection of the DZMB Wilhelmshaven. As a method for exploring species richness and speeding up accurate species identification, a fragment of the mitochondrial cytochrome oxidase subunit 1 is added to each identified species. Therefore, an aliquot of each high-quality DNA extract will be sent to the molecular lab of the International Barcode of Life project in Gulf, Canada. To investigate the effectiveness of the CO1 gene to provide species-level identifications for a wide variety of zooplankton taxa, we sequenced CO1 from 173 zooplankton specimens, including meroplanktonic larvae. Since meroplanktonic larval stages are often difficult to identify morphologically, we additionally tested the identification of some common crustacean larval stages by means of DNA barcodes. Therefore, larvae were sorted into 5 distinct morphotypes and compared to known CO1 sequences from 52 morphologically identified adult specimens. The DNA barcoding approach applied for the identification of the crustacean larvae was effective in identifying 20 from 21 specimens. The larval sequences are grouped with sequences of known taxonomic identity from our sequence library. All groups are well supported by high bootstrap values at the major nodes. The 5 morphotypes A to E each represent a distinct species. Sequence divergence within clades ranged from 0 to 0.68%, while divergence among congeneric species ranged from 10.9% to 18.3%. Subsequently, we manually aligned all 173 zooplankton sequences, including sequences of the identified larvae, with the Genius sequence editor. The neighbor joining profile contained 34 terminal nodes, each representing a different species of the major zooplankton groups. Multiple individuals of one species grouped together, supported by bootstrap values of over 99%. Further examination of the tree additionally revealed evidence for the clustering of taxonomically allied species. The study reported here identified 95% of the larval sequences to species level, which showed 100% matches to the entries in our sequence library. Moreover, our preliminary results provide evidence that using the CO1 gene is highly effective in discriminating zooplankton species, since the level of sequence variation between representatives of one species is much lower than between closely related species. Hence, our sequence library of morphologically identified species, combined with larval stages that hampers traditional morphological identification, provides a valuable tool ideally suited to studying the biodiversity of the metazoan fauna of the North Sea through a barcoding approach. Nevertheless, in order to build a workable identification tool based on DNA barcoding, there is need for close collaboration with taxonomic experts.